Hi, this is Michelle, and I'm a technical marketing engineer for the product enablement team. In this video, I'll demonstrate the value of using the next or previous function when creating derived fields in customer journey analytics. Let's get started. For my use case, I want to create a new dimension that concatenates up to three marketing channel values based on the next value behavior at the user level. Then I could use this new dimension to answer questions like, what are the most popular combinations of marketing channels that users interact with before going in store? Or, which marketing channel combinations drive the highest revenue? If you're familiar with Adobe Analytics, you might recall that cookie-based JavaScript plugins or processing rules were used for this purpose. Now, the first thing I'll do is open data views and then components. It's worth mentioning that you need proper access to edit data views. So if you don't see the link at the top, you'll need to address that first. Once I'm in my data view, I'll click the Create Derived Field button. This opens the builder where I'll create my new derived dimension. In the left column, all available functions to choose from are displayed. I'll locate Next or Previous and then drop it to the middle of the builder. I'm presented with the input fields for the role. First, I'll choose the input field under Value. For my use case, it's the marketing channel. The method I'm using is Next Value, and you'll see Previous Value is available here as well. There are two options for scope, Person and Session. Again, my use case is based on the user level, so I'll select Person. The index number I'll use for this rule is relative to the base marketing channel value, which is 1. Last, I'll include repeats in my dimension. This setting impacts how the initial value for the first index is set, specifically the incidences of returning blank values. Refer to the help documentation for more details. So far, I have a handle on the initial next value returned from my first role. I have two more levels remaining. I'll add a second role using the next or previous function below the first one. The settings are very similar to the first role with these exceptions. The result of role 1 is automatically used as the value input for role 2. This is what I want since I'll ultimately chain the previous values together. I'll update the index to use 2 since it's relative to the value in rule 1. On to my last level. I'll add another rule using the next or previous function below the second rule. It automatically assigns the value to the output of rule 2, which is what I need. I'll update the index value to 3 and use the same method, scope, and include repeats settings. Last, to accomplish my goal for this new dimension, I'll add another rule. I want a concatenated value comprised of a maximum of 3 marketing channels. I'll use the concatenate function for this purpose. This function allows me to combine field values together into a single derived field. Once I drop this below my last role, I'm presented with the configuration inputs. First, I need to update the value to use the output of rule 1, since that's the first value I want to include in the concatenated string. I have the option to set the derived field only if all 3 values are present. The derived field would only be set if all 3 values exist from rules 1 through 3. I'll finish configuring the settings by specifying a delimiter and adding the output of rules 2 and 3 to the role. On the right, I'll name my field and add a description. The data type for this field is automatically set. As expected, you can only use string fields with this function. Now I'll save the new derived field. Once it's saved, I'll add it to my data view by dropping it 2 dimensions. It's important to remember to save your changes to the data view at this point so that the new derived dimension is available for reporting. In the workspace project, I have access to the new dimension in the metrics selector, and I can use it in my report. Hopefully, the next or previous function enhances your ability to answer questions about value set prior to or after an initial value and analyze these against key events in your product. Good luck!